Alright. I'm tired, knackered, and you know, and I'm like, well, okay, so I'll use the word I used today. I was working, you know. And then I'm like, well, when I use the word working, it goes to the preconceived conceptions that the people have in their minds there already, what it means, what its adequacy is and represent, or its inadequacy. And yet also, I'm here wondering, why? Why does it have to be this exact predicament of ownership with people? Why are they so keen on the ownership protocol of the word work and what it represents? Because by being so keen on its ownership, on what people are doing, how they're doing it, when they're doing it, aren't you just really rallying yourself back, you know, 200-300 years to a slave ship, in essence? Being that owner of people, that's particularate, that judge per diem, you know, what are you doing? So it's like, well, maybe there's too many of you. Maybe there's too many of you with that mindset, with that particular. You know, because what's the big deal? What's the big deal about it? You know, why is it such a heavy haul on so many people that they have to rally, life, live, and speak, with what the others are doing, in some kind of a measured temperament? You know, a measured moment. And if it's not measured against another person or another set of persons, You know, it has to be measured. Every human being has to be measured for some reason, in this particular stream of group thinkers. I'll call them group thinkers because they're all like group thinkers. Like they're all getting into a car together and they all think the same thing. You know. So yeah, I don't know. It's an odd, strange, heavy. What is their big why, you know? What is their big why? That's all I'm asking. That's all. I can understand in certain cases, you know, perhaps I can understand, you know, maybe there are excesses or people who take advantage or something. But when the person is not excessive and does not take advantage, then I'm not understanding. I'm not understanding the that's a work judgmental group. The work judgmental group coming through and just knives for no reason, you know. Where would that be from? Where would that abuse cycle come from in them? Other than they get their jollies off on the high of being owners over others. That's what I see it as. They're high on being owners over others. So yeah, serious. It's a serious deal. So anyway, I really did not want to talk about that, but that group, it really does tee me off sometimes. I want to talk more about, you know, bringing in, you know, just into the clearing of their mind, the clearing of your mind space, and how much difficult it is sometimes to clear that mind space out, because there's so much encumbrance, so much baggage ever, and I'm like, well, gosh dang, I sound like a repeat cycle, maybe that's all I am, a repeat cycle. But it does not matter, maybe it's the first time you heard it. Anyway, so there's the encumbrant baggage, you know, it's everything, the good, the bad, the uglies that people have said all throughout your life, those types of baggages, you know, that encumbrance group. And so when you're trying to clear your mind, that means all of those whisks in that you receive, you have to whisk them away, you know, just be completely clear and into a blank space. When you go into a complete blank space, you know, and then we go back to, you could say, to the empty vessel or whatever, the empty vessel, that does not have, doesn't hold, doesn't even think in this time. It doesn't even know 24 hours. You know, complete blank vessel does not live on a time scale. It is something that is accepting. It is something that meanders. It is something that does not stop. It is a flow. It is a free flow. When it is a complete blank, empty vessel, there is a freedom of what it accepts and what it doesn't accept. There is that moment. You can bring up some kind of devices, I believe so. And that is the journey, is to make sure when you bring up those devices against, you know, the acceptance or the deacceptance into the vessel, that you don't block it. You don't actually block the flow. Yeah, so it's a difficult tough, isn't it? A difficult tough. Because it means leaving. It means leaving everything around you. It means leaving the here. It means leaving the now. It means leaving the items on the walls. It means leaving the house you're in. All metaphysically, all through your mind. It means leaving the tips from Heloise or something, the tips and the hints from Heloise, even though, you know, she may, when you are there in your meditative state, she may even bring it up, you know, like, what? And all of a sudden you're going to get a tip from Heloise, you know, out of the blue, and like, no, I don't want that, you know, coming in through the vessel, and that's something you maybe have to block, you know, it's not the flow. You know, so sometimes these things do, they're dashing in, and you're like, how come? You know, I didn't want to think that thought. I didn't want to think that thought, especially if it's a negative thought. How come the negatives can come in and attack you? I mean, how dare they? Where do they come from, you know? And then in the mind space of being like a pure innocent, and you're having the attacks come in, it is felt immediately as if, oh my gosh, the others have some heinousness against me, you know. So you're thinking that already, that it's where they're coming from. So you're just feeling like it's just their arrows at you. You're just feeling like they're the attackers, you know. And because you are there and you are pure and you are innocent, in that moment of complete blank, empty, and acceptance, you're essentially their sling board or whatever, their easy attack plate. And even from consciousness cycle to consciousness cycle, yeah, your consciousness cycle to theirs and vice versa, they are bringing in their negative consciousness to you. And so that's the attack you feel. So I don't understand the hints from Heloise. I understand the negativity ones coming in, but when it's almost like maybe those types of stupid, really ridiculous ones are more like interrupters, aren't they? They're more like interrupters, like interruptions. Just maybe that in itself, you know, bring the interruption, bring the busy in, you know, as if, you know, those ones out there are like, you're not allowed that. So it goes back to the owner. It goes back to the owner pandemonium. We want to own what you do. We want to own what you say. We want to own how you think. We want to own how you live, and we want to own how you work. So it goes back to that group of the owners again. So when the owner pandemonium is like even thinking, no, we need hints from Heloise tonight or whatever. You know, you're free in that space, that empty vessel. You're free, all right? And because you are free, it is showing through. There, you know, maybe that was just like a standard, not such a mean sentiment, thought speak, but it still made it through. You know, so I feel like, what do you call that? It's like the innocent sheep, innocent lamb, just the innocent that is easily, you know, when you have the negations against you, just on a minimal scale, or she should be doing, or he should be doing, there's an interruption state. And the interruption state is, well, there comes a hint from Heloise, necessary. Or, oh my gosh, you know, I have to paint the room green tomorrow or something. Or something that's a pandemonium away from your allowed place of breathing and existing. You know, it's almost as if we are journeying deeper and deeper into who's who here. You know, who's who in charge of my own body? Who's who in charge of my own mind? When these people do try to interject again and again and again, and even in their own headspace, even they could live hundreds and hundreds of miles away, they inject the negative energies at me. It would be really great, you know, in the future if we find out it's absolutely proven that they did cause a disruption, and they did cause what do we call it? I guess it would almost be a crime. It would be a head crime. So they would cause the head crime to another from a distance. So yeah, so let's try to not have head crimes. Maybe that's the way to go. Yeah. Yeah.